Hey guys, welcome back to a new video. I'm sorry for not uploading over the last week, but as you can probably still hear in my voice, I'm still a bit sick, and also there wasn't really anything going on with Battlefield 2042, so I didn't want to just push out a random video just to upload something. But now, since we just got the patch notes for patch 7.2 coming on May 14th, of course it's worth making a video about it, since this will probably be the last patch we will ever get for this game, at least like the last big balance patch. Of course they will do maintenance on this game, as they said, but this is probably the last big patch. So what are we getting with this patch? Well, first of all, we are getting the new bomber and the new LMG. If you want to unlock those two things, you have to play the mode Control Unlocked, where you basically have to get ribbons like always for the free skins. And with 40 ribbons you get the bomber, and with 80 ribbons you get the Strife LMG. So if you want to get the Strife LMG, I think on average you can do like 10 or 12 ribbons in a round, so you will need to play at least I think like 7 or 8 rounds if you really try your best to get those ribbons to unlock these. Then they are teasing an all new event that is coming in the future. There really isn't much info other than there will be some honorable cosmetics, so I expect you get like 1 or 2 skins again, and then there are like 5 shop skins you can buy for real money. Then they are changing attack helicopters. So they're saying we have lowered the damage of the TOW missile against heavy and medium armored vehicles, tanks, wildcats and ram, and we also have lowered the damage of anti-vehicle rocket pods to the same category of vehicles by 20%. So this means if you are somebody that likes to drive around in armored vehicles and the enemy has an attack helicopter, you probably don't explode as fast now. Now another change they are making is to Irish's APS. They say they are aware of the long-lasting issue that vehicles are basically just camping on a hill, placing Irish's APS near them, and then you as an infantry, you basically have the problem that you can't shoot the tank with your rockets because the APS would intercept the rockets. Now with patch 7.2, they are actually removing this feature in quotation marks, and you as infantry can now finally go after those tanks without having to take care of Irish's APS first. But I think it's a good change, because in Conquest, I'm pretty sure most of the time tanks are sitting literally on a hill and sniping you across the map, and when you then switch to an engineer and you try to get close and shoot a rocket, it's basically your first rocket gets intercepted by the first APS, your next rocket by the other APS, and then most tanks also have an APS, I'm pretty sure, so 3 of your rockets are just wasted. So vehicle hunting alone is basically impossible, and with them also removing the 3C5 from like Sundance and McKay's, now I think this balances out a bit more again. Next up, a change I don't understand, and they are touching McKay again. So the first thing they are doing is they increase the cooldown of the grapple from 11 seconds to 25 seconds. And here, well, the thing is, I can understand it. McKay is the only specialist that can sit in places you don't expect him to be. Of course, you could also count Sundance in there, but for Sundance to land in places where she isn't supposed to be, she needs to actually jump from somewhere. With McKay, he can just grapple everywhere. And I also understand that it can be quite frustrating having a McKay sitting in a spot you didn't expect, because he's the only specialist that can get there basically. But I don't think changing the cooldown will do anything other than making McKay players more frustrated with playing McKay, since honestly I think for most people they don't really think about if McKay has 11 seconds or a 25 seconds cooldown or even a minute cooldown. It will always be frustrating for the normal player to get shot at from an angle they didn't expect because McKay grappled up there. So I understand the design philosophy why they want to give McKay a bigger cooldown, but at the end of the day, even if you give it like a 1 minute cooldown, people will still be pissed getting shot from some random angle. So the problem is more with that his gadget overall is just broken and you can't really balance it properly, so it's like a bandage fix. So, and here's another change I don't really understand, and also I don't agree with, and this is his trait Nimble, which gives him a boost to movement speed when aiming down sight. They nerfed from 40% to 25%. This common theme in this patch, by the way, they tried to make the game slower for whatever reason. But I don't understand why they are nerfing McKay this way. His Nimble trait, or the reason why McKay is so favored by a lot of players, of course the grappling hook, but for me when I play him, It's basically the ADS suite. McKay is the only specialist that doesn't feel like you're glued to the ground, and he's also the only specialist that can properly play LMGs or heavier guns without it feeling like you're basically standing still. So instead of nerfing his movement speed, why are they not buffing the other character's movement speed? In my opinion, a better option would have been to bring up the other specialist by like 15% or something, since if you increase the movement speed while ADSing for the other specialists by 15%, McKay would still be 25% faster, but all the other operators or specialists would also feel a lot better. But now they decided to just make him slower for whatever reason. Now another change they're doing is this for the systematic repair for vehicles again. Another problem tanks usually have is that tanks and I think every vehicle in the game has a self-repair. What happens in a lot of games, even if you can land rockets on a tank because the APS are down, so they didn't bring any, a lot of tanks just roll back down the hill in cover, do like the self-repair thingy, and then like come back 20 seconds later and it looks like you never shot a bullet or a rocket at them. And now what they are basically doing, they nerf their self-repair. Currently they repair 25 HP in 5 seconds, now it takes them 8.6 seconds. Then here are some general improvements, and now here's some more weapon balancing. Now here are also a few things I don't understand. First of all, they nerfed the P90 PP2000 AKS 74U by slightly slowing down the fire dispersion reset. I don't know why they would do it. Those guns are barely ever picked anyways. Why would you nerf them even more? Now the AM40 gets nerfed. The standard issue damage under 10 meters changed from 26 to 24. Before you could actually four shot with the AM40 up to 10 meters. What made the gun have an incredible TTK, and I think especially on Redacted where the VHX dominated, a lot of people actually changed to the AM40 since the AM40 was now basically doing the same damage as the VHX was doing before. This is no longer the case. I don't really mind this change too much. I think the AM40 still has a really good TTK up close. Then they also made it so that the AM40 dispersion has a horizontal recoil increased by 5%. I'm not that big of a fan of horizontal recoil, but since you play it in close quarters anyways, I don't think you will notice it that much. Now the VHX D3 high power ammo damage under 20 meters changed from 25 to 24. So I think there's even less reason to run high power now on the gun. And LCMG dispersion when using the short barrel attachment increased by 10%, so you got to burst a bit more. So then they made some visual recoil improvements, so I hope this means less visual recoil. Well, they did some tweaks and improvements for the following weapons and scope combinations. I will just blend them in here, but we got basically the PBX45, PP29, P90, AKS74U and PP2000. Then they did some more improvements for the sidearms, or for heavy sidearms, M44, so the Magnum Revolver, ETC added helping, so I think like the Desert Eagle and the Rex, I think those three count as like heavy sidearms. And of course for the scopes. Then they did some improvements on assault rifles for the AK, VHX, GW46, MTA, and the ACOG side. I think the only gun out of them that needed an improvement was the GW. I think I had someone tell me under some of my videos that the GW was basically unusable after the visual recoil change, so hopefully now the gun is usable again. And then also on the LMGs, improvements to the visual recoil, particularly when using thermal sights, Raven, ACOG, and Bravo sights, and further improvements to create radical points closer to screen center. This is a bullshit statement, and further improvements to create radical point closer to screen center. You can basically just program it so that it always stays on screen center. I don't know why they're not doing it, but well. Then some more vehicle adjustments, I will put them up on screen. And yeah, that's basically the whole patch. What do I think of it? I think the vehicle changes are good. I don't like the McKay change. I think the grapple changes, whatever, it just feels probably way worse to play him now after the update than before. But I don't think it will change much on how like how you use him. I can still get in the positions I want and piss off the enemy team, so that's not much of a problem. I just have to be a bit more mindful about my cooldowns. And yeah, the movement speed nerf, I think it's complete bullshit. I would rather see them buff the rest of the roster instead of nerfing him, but that's just my take. And yeah, as for the weapon changes, some of it I can understand, some of it I don't, but whatever. So yeah, I would now be interested in hearing from you guys what you think about this patch. Do you enjoy the changes? Do you think it's too little? Or would you love to see something else changed that they didn't mention in the patch or have no plans on changing? Just let me know down in the comments below. And as always, thank you so much for watching the video until the end. If you enjoyed this video, consider leaving a like and subscribing for future content. And I will see you in the next one.